Good evening. I'm Brett Gritzmacher, the proud principal of Brookfield Central High School, and welcome to the Class of 2020 Senior Honors Night. Senior Honors Night is a long-standing tradition at Brookfield Central. It is our event to recognize the best of the best from the BC senior class. Thank you to all the parents and family members that are watching this event, but also thank you for your guidance that you have provided your sons and daughters. Additionally, thank you to the entire BC Student Services staff, Greg Groh, Heather Lemke, Jessica Primo, Jenny Catricius, Paul Kellner, Nicole Gruby, and in particular, Leah Devine, Tracy Rink, and Amber Bosch for their great work in organizing this special event. Thank you to Dan Pronley, the entire BC maintenance staff, and to Magic Productions that filmed and produced the event. Our host and hostess for Senior Honors Night are BC juniors Ryer Gritzmacher and Brianna Rette. They will do most of the introductions of our guests and award recipients. But first, I'm going to turn it over to BC Associate Principal, Mr. Dominic Bauer.
The following students have sustained academic excellence over the past 4 years by earning a cumulative grade point average of 4.0 or higher.
Neha Ajampour, Gabriel Alwan, Zara Amar, Sonia Aurora, Abraham Balding, Ellen Barker, Emily Berger, Andrew Blake, Laura Boggier, Brenda Bompon Benediba, Megan Brown, Gabriella Brueggemann, Caitlin Berzinski, Emily Bush, Leah Cape, Stephanie Chen, Chandra Chowan, Maggie Conlin, Michael Cravello, Eliane Del Campo, Nisha Desai, Iksha Dawan, Elizabeth Doan, Margaret Doyle, Caroline Durham, Caitlin Alenteni, Tylen Frokania, Riley Feng, Julia Fernandez, Liam Flatley, Eliana Fuchs, Kaylin Gringo, Shreya Gupta, Rowan Hamada, Thomas Harmeyer, Andrew Hodgson, Sean Hughes, Nabil Hassani, Nora Ibrahim, Peter Zhang, Ryan Johnson, Augie Jerva, Monish Kalia, Isha Kapoor, Hannah Keehan, Carissa Kennart, Laura Knapp, Gwen Knutson, Noelle Cotterly, Samantha Krutz, Anna Kult, Isabella Ledesma,
Kyle Lee, Brandon Lee, Mia Lyakopoulos, Jana Ling, Emily Liu, Norman Liu, John Labaki, Ryan Lacante, Anya Logan, Sophia Maida, Abigail Manby, Vaishnavi Menakonda, Matthew Mauerman, Thomas Maurice, Astrid Merritt, Daphne Milkert, Jonah Morioka, Michael Miller, Zoe Nagirade, Andrew Ang, Emily Otten, Shweta Penda, Rachel Peel, Ellery Prusco, Mary Quinn, Ishan Raikar, Vaibhav Rajesh, Ananya Rajesh, Rhea Ramachandran, Abraham Ragnar, Gwendolyn Ryan, Lauren Roscoff, Leonardo Ruiz, Tejas Sagubadi, Lucas Schmidt, Benjamin Siegert, Anurag Srikanth Belavadi, Sydney Smith, Zachary Smith, Julianne Sun, Dana Tabaza, Jacob Tan, Molly Thomas, Warren Trice, Molly Turco, Michaela Utenheimer, Nicole Vanzolo, Alyssa Vetta, Grace Vraney, Andy Wang, Madeline Walensky, Nicole Yang, Nikki Yelmin.
The following students are being recognized for showing a significant GPA increase since freshman year. Congratulations to Jesse Arenzi, Ella Kuna, Benjamin Fuller, Antonio Galarza, and Nathan Roberts.
Over 50,000 commended students throughout the nation are being recognized for their exceptional academic promise. Commended students placed among the top 5% of more than 1 million students who entered the 2019 to 2020 merit program by taking the 2018 PSAT. Our commended students are Andrew Hodgson, Nabil Hassani, Jonah Morioka, and Ishan Riker.
From more than 1 million students who entered the 2019-2020 National Merit Program, only 16,000 were named National Merit Finalists. To obtain this distinction, the student had to submit a detailed scholarship application and present a record on very high academic performance. This year, BCHS has 9 students who were named as finalists. They are Neha Ajimpour, Stephanie Chen, Tylan Farokhnia, Nora Ibrahim, Cameron Coleman, Augie Jerva, Emily Liu, Shweta Panda, and Nicole Yang.
National Merit Scholarship winners are the finalists from each state judged to have the strongest combination of accomplishments, skills, and potential for success in rigorous college studies. They were selected by a committee of college admissions officers and high school counselors. These scholars may use their awards at any accredited U.S. college or university. We are pleased to announce that we have two winners. They are Neja Ajampour and Stephanie Chen.
The United States Presidential Scholars Program was established in 1964 to recognize and honor our nation's most distinguished graduating high school seniors. Each year, some 3,000 candidates nationwide are identified for the academic component of the program, based on having scored exceptionally well on the College Board SAT or ACT. This year, Brookfield Central has two Presidential Scholar semifinalists. They are Liam Flatley and Emily Liu.
The purpose of the Cole Excellence Scholarship Program is to recognize student leadership, citizenship, school and community involvement, and academic achievement. The goal is to encourage Wisconsin youth to pursue post-secondary education in a public or non-public university, college, or vocational/technical college. The foundation awarded $10,000 scholarships to 100 high school graduates this year. This year, Brookfield Central is honored to have one winner. Congratulations, Riley Feng.
Wisconsin's top high school seniors are awarded the Academic Excellence Scholarship. The AES provides up to $2,250 per year for tuition at a Wisconsin college or university for up to 4 years. Our recipients are Stephanie Chen, Liam Flatley, and Andrew Eng.
In addition, Wisconsin's top high school seniors are awarded the Technical Excellence Scholarships to seniors who have demonstrated the highest level of proficiency in technical education subjects. The TES provides up to $2,200 per year for tuition at a Wisconsin technical college system for up to 3 years. Our recipients this year are Tyler Babaloba, Gabriella Brueggemann, and Sunny Vang. Congratulations.
Our Class of 2020 Salutatorian Address will be given by BC Salutatorian Liam Flatley.
A few months ago, I was at a dance convention, learning a short snippet of a dance from a renowned teacher. I had to learn the combination quickly, and I later had to perform this combination in front of my peers and teachers. The teacher kept shouting out, "Transitions! Transitions! Don't lose the transitions." I disagreed with him, and I thought his comment was actually incredibly stupid. See, in dance, the kicks, the large leaps, and the many turns gets people's attention. Certainly not the quick little steps in between these moves. Why would I try to embrace a transition as opposed to an actually noticeable movement? It certainly would help me in getting attention from those around me, which, at the end of the day, is vital in dance. I tend to organize life with the same perspective I had when learning that combination. There are milestones in life, the kicks, the leaps, and the turns, and then there's the time leading up to that milestone, the quick steps, the transitions. After this dance teacher nearly broke my eardrums with his seemingly obtuse comment, I became eager to truly dissect what he was saying. So I'd like to share what I came up with, the four most important aspects of a transitional period. Aspect one, they don't seem to matter. The grouping recognized tonight consists of incredibly high-achieving students, and as a result, we're always working towards our next biggest goal, getting that grade, getting into that college, getting that job. The time in between these large movements, the day-to-day grind, is relatively insignificant. Don't believe me? Well, at this very moment, seniors, no one cares about your performance, your freshman, sophomore, or junior years. We've all achieved the long-run goal of getting into college and soon graduating, and this is what seems to matter the most. Take your pestering relatives, for example. I'm sure we've all gotten the, what are you doing after high school, but haven't once been asked, what classes did you take your freshman year? No one really cares about your time working towards something. All that seems to matter is whether you get there or not. Aspect number two, we spend most of our life in transitional phases. Our freshman, sophomore, junior, and the early part of our senior year have been spent working towards the big milestone, graduating. The students being recognized tonight have spent 3.5 years dedicating hours upon hours to our academics just to have this little moment of joy where we can feel like we've made it to the other side. And while my seniors have achieved their high school goals, we'll soon leave for college. And this, unfortunately, is another long waiting room that we'll have to endure until we reach our next biggest goal, securing a job or getting into graduate school. Right now, we're also in another waiting room with the rest of America. We await the reopening of society, stressed with the uncertainty of whether or not we'll get to see our fellow class again, celebrate our success at a graduation, or even pursue college in the fall. This brings me to the third aspect of a transition. I'm sure we've all heard the saying, stop and smell the roses. And to be honest, I have mixed feelings about this quote. The concept, in my opinion, is golden, but the saying is overused and needs to be upgraded to be truly applicable to what I'm trying to convey here. The countless, never-ending transitional periods we face are made up of a field of a million roses, millions of opportunities that are waiting to be taken, not just one or two. In addition, to say that a person can only smell roses is quite naive. There are many ways to enjoy transitional periods, not just one. So for my seniors, and frankly anyone else who is in a waiting room, not only do I challenge you to stop and smell them on your way to achievement, but to roll around in them, throw them, make a beautiful bouquet out of them, pick them, touch them, save them. And finally, the fourth and most important aspect of transitions, never wait. The seniors being recognized tonight have learned a valuable lesson, albeit through an unfortunate ending, that other grades, classes, and people may never learn the true value of. We've all undoubtedly worked hard and made sacrifices to achieve our high school goals. Some of us have given up hanging out with friends, football games, and weekend family activities just so we could work towards getting here. I know that, especially for this group of talented people, the last 2 months of senior year were supposed to be unlike any other. It would have been a time to unwind. We've achieved what we wanted, and now we can finally enjoy the things that we missed out on our way here. Yet now, due to unfortunate circumstances, we can't go back and enjoy the bountiful fields of flowers we missed out on our way here. In other words, we will never get back the opportunities we took for granted while in transition. So, for the seniors being recognized tonight, and frankly anyone else watching this, I encourage you to approach the next transitional phase of your life in a different manner by remembering to run free in their endless fields of roses. Thank you.
We are honored to have Colonel Michael Robertson, class of 1993 United States Military Academy at West Point, here to make a special announcement.
Good evening, and thank you, Principal Gritzmacher and Mr. and Mrs. Hodson, for allowing me to be a part of this prestigious occasion to honor Andrew Hodson. I'm Michael Robertson, a colonel in the United States Army Reserve and a 1993 graduate of West Point. The mission of West Point is to educate, train, and inspire the Corps of Cadets so that each graduate is a commissioned leader of character, committed to the values of duty, honor, country, and prepare for a career of professional excellence and service to the nation as an officer in the United States Army. In fact, West Point is considered the premier leadership institution in the world. In addition to leadership, West Point is also among the nation's top academic institutions. It has produced more Rhodes Scholars than any other college or university in the country, with the exception of Harvard, Yale, and Princeton. It has also produced more Hertz Fellows, the scientific equivalent of the Rhodes, than all other schools except for MIT, Stanford, and Princeton. West Point cadets also undergo rigorous physical training, leadership development, and moral ethical training in order to develop those attributes necessary to serve as a commissioned leader of character and an active duty Army officer, serving our soldiers, our Army, and our nation. Andrew competed with over 15,000 candidates this past year from around the nation for one of less than 1,200 appointments. Candidates were evaluated on a basis of academic excellence, leadership potential, and athletic ability. He will become a member of the Long Gray Line and the recipient of an academic and leadership development education valued at over $400,000. To quote General Norman Schwarzkopf, a West Point graduate, from his speech delivered to the U.S. Corps of Cadets upon the successful culmination of our victory in Desert Storm, "The mothers and fathers of America will give you their sons and daughters. They will hand you their sons and daughters with the confidence that you will not needlessly waste their lives. And you dare not. You absolutely dare not. That's the burden the mantle of leadership places upon you. It is an awesome responsibility and one that you must prepare yourself for. If there is any doubt about the future and strength of the United States of America, all one must do is look to the proud young man whom we celebrate this evening, and you will know that our future is secure. On behalf of the President of the United States and the Superintendent of the United States Military Academy, it is my honor and privilege to announce the appointment of Andrew Hodson to the United States Military Academy at West Point. Congratulations.
The Daughters of the American Revolution Good Citizens Award and Scholarship Contest, created in 1934, is intended to encourage and reward the qualities of good citizenship. This award recognizes and rewards individuals who possess the qualities of dependability, service, leadership, and patriotism in their homes, schools, and communities. These students are selected by their teachers and peers because they demonstrate these qualities to an outstanding degree. This year's recipient of the DAR Good Citizens Award is Andrew Hodgson.
Hello, everyone. My name is Ellen Linehan, and I am the coordinator for the local program for Distinguished Young Women for Brookfield. And I'm here today to present an award to several of our participants from our class of 2020. So founded in 1958, Distinguished Young Women is the largest and oldest national scholarship program for high school girls. It has provided life-changing experiences for more than 765,000 young women across the country and more than $108 million in cash scholarships at the local, state, and national levels. In addition to cash scholarships, Distinguished Young Women participants are eligible for college-granted scholarships from over 100 colleges and universities. More than $1 billion in college scholarship opportunities were provided last year, some of which included full tuition, room and board to first-class institutions. From our local program, we had several awards. The Spirit Award, which is selected by the girls themselves, was shared by both McKenna Popek and Rhea Ramachandran. The fundraising awards went to McKenna Popek, Kate Brzezinski, Riley Feng, Rhea Ramachandran, and Ananya Rajesh. For Scholastics, our overall award was Neha Ajampour, and our alternate Scholastic award went to Riley Feng. The overall talent award went to Riley Feng, and the alternate talent awards went to Ellery Prusco and Rhea Ramachandran. For overall fitness, it was Riley Feng. Alternate fitness was Rhea Ramachandran and Ananya Rajesh. For overall self-expression, it was Neha Ajampour. For alternate self-expression, it was Ananya Rajesh and Riley Feng. For overall interview, it was Ananya Rajesh. Alternate interview went to Riley Feng. Our third alternate for the program was Neha Ajampour. The first alternate for the program was Ananya Rajesh. And the Distinguished Young Women of Brookfield of 2020 was Riley Feng. An at-large qualifier who participated in our local program but does not live in Brookfield was McKenna Popek. She was acknowledged as Distinguished Young Woman of Pewaukee for 2020. At the state program last August, both of our girls represented our community of Brookfield Central. McKenna Popek was awarded the Overall Talent Award, and Riley Feng was awarded Distinguished Young Woman of Wisconsin. Riley will be competing nationally next month with the program that takes place normally in Mobile, Alabama. However, Riley will be participating virtually, which is a brand new experience, and we wish her all the best in her endeavors, and we are very excited to announce that she will be attending Stanford University in the fall. Thank you so much.
I would like to welcome Mrs. Beth Dobrzynski to Senior Honors Night to present the Elmbrook Education Foundation Scholarships.
Good evening. I am Beth Dobrzynski, Executive Director of the Elmbrook Education Foundation. In 1958, three $500 scholarships were awarded to Brookfield High School students by a volunteer group of parents and community members. It has since grown into a community-wide scholarship program made possible through the generosity of honorary and memorial funds, community groups, businesses, and school PTOs. Having the EEF administer the program helps ensure that the greatest number of seniors can be honored by our community each year. The EEF takes great care to select recipients that meet the criteria provided by the scholarship sponsors. Over $1.4 million in scholarships has been awarded to our community's graduating seniors through the Elmbrook Education Foundation. In addition to scholarships, the Elmbrook Education Foundation has given over $425,000 in grant money to our district schools to promote innovative instruction and teaching excellence since 2001. And within the last year, we have contributed $20,000 to the Elmbrook Music Program. This year, the foundation, on behalf of our very generous donors, will award 30 $1,500 scholarships to students at Brookfield Central and Brookfield East. Tonight, I am honored to present the following scholarships to our graduating Brookfield Central seniors. These students exhibit not only educational excellence, but also leadership and service to their school and community. The BCHS PTO Honorary Scholarship is for a graduating senior who has been active in their school community and has a recognized passion for school service. This year's recipient is an excellent student, musician, and leader at Brookfield Central. She served as a section leader and drum major of the band, secretary of Key Club, led scouting for the Beast First robotics team at state and international competitions, has played French horn with MISO since sixth grade, and played JV tennis throughout high school. In service to her community, she also mentored a middle school first Lego League team that went to Worlds, served at Girl Scout camp for four summers, worked with a team of Code the Way interns to develop software for the Convergence Resource Center in Milwaukee, and is active in her church. She will be majoring in computer science at St. Olaf in the fall. The BCHS PTO is proud to present this year's BCHS PTO Honorary Scholarship to Anya Logan. The Charles Turner Honorary Scholarship was established to honor Charles for the support and encouragement he provided Brookfield Central athletes as a physical education teacher and coach from 1965 until 2003. He officially retired in 1989. This fund provides a scholarship to a BCHS student who has been active in track and cross country each year. This recipient is an outstanding scholar and athlete, lettering in both cross country and track and field at Brookfield Central. She was nominated as the Journal Sentinel Cross Country Athlete of the Year in 2020. In addition, she participates in National Honor Society, Link Mentor Program, Key Club, and Ski Club. Her community service has included teaching in Sunday school, where she found her young students to be a great inspiration. She will be studying biology to pursue a career in healthcare. I am very proud to present the Charles Turner Honorary Scholarship to Caroline Durham. I would like to read a message from the sponsor of the First Weber Foundation Honorary Scholarship. The First Weber Foundation is dedicated to having a positive impact in the community our agents and employees serve throughout the state of Wisconsin, and we're especially proud to be able to support the educational goals of this scholarship recipient. There's nothing more inspiring than watching potential of youth mature into adult leadership, and we're confident that the student will continue to make their community proud in the years to come. Thank you for the opportunity, and we can't wait to see what's next for our recipient. This recipient was an exemplary student at Brookfield Central High School, achieving a high GPA while participating in a wide variety of school activities. He completed many advanced placement and honors classes. He was team captain of the mock trial team and participated in Beast Robotics. He was a board member of the Spanish Honor Society, as well as a member of the Brookfield Central tennis team. In his spare time, he enjoys writing and recording songs and has released multiple albums. In the fall, he plans to attend Northwestern University. On behalf of the First Weber Foundation, I am proud to present the First Weber Foundation Honorary Scholarship to Nabil Hussani. The Foch Family Foundation awards two scholarships annually to two graduating seniors pursuing their education at a Catholic university. This year, two recipients were selected from Brookfield Central. Our first recipient is planning to study biology at St. Louis University or Creighton University. She serves on the executive board for the Fellowship of Christian Athletes and is a member of the Key Club and National Honor Society. She has received letters in swim and dive, cross country, and track and field. She also served as a vacation Bible school leader and Sunday school teacher. On behalf of the Foch Family Foundation, I am proud to present the Foch Family Foundation Honorary Scholarship to Gabriella Brigeman. Our second recipient is a very accomplished student planning to major in chemistry at Boston College. He was a drum major in the marching band, a member of the BC Pitt Orchestra, varsity boys swim dive team, and jazz band. He was a member of the Milwaukee Youth Symphony Orchestra and mentored band students at Swanson Elementary. He was selected as a finalist for the Honors Performance Series programs and has played in Carnegie Hall and the Sydney Opera House. He will be playing in the Musique Verein in Austria this summer. On behalf of the Foch Family Foundation, I am very proud to present the Foch Family Foundation Honorary Scholarship to Kyle Lee. The Foch Family Foundation awards two scholarships annually to two students who will further their education at a technical school, one for each high school. Our recipient is planning to pursue a nursing degree at Waukesha County Technical College. While attending Brookfield Central, she participated in cheerleading and served as the band majorette. She also participated in Girl Scouts and performed in multiple community parades. She has worked throughout high school and plans to become a certified nurse practitioner. On behalf of the Foch family, I am proud to present the Foch Family Foundation Technical School Honorary Scholarship to Julia Hickey. The Hillside Student Honorary Scholarship was established when Hillside Elementary closed in 2012 to provide a legacy for those Hillside alumni. This scholarship is fully funded through the graduating class of Hillside Kindergartners in 2025. This recipient is a well-rounded student and athlete at Brookfield Central and former Hillside Elementary student. She is a varsity tennis player serving as team captain her senior year. In addition, she served on the executive board of Key Club, officer board of DECA, National Honor Society, and Lancer Link Mentor. Her passion for volunteering and service to her community includes helping with meal programs and local nursing homes. I am very proud to present the Hillside Student Honorary Scholarship to Nisha Desai. Please welcome John and Carrie Stahl as they award the two Holly Christina Stahl Love Life Memorial Scholarships.
Hi, we're John and Carrie Stahl, and we're here to announce the recipients of the Holly Christina Stahl Love Life Scholarships for 2020. Our first recipient is Mia Leocopoulos. Mia is an accomplished student and inspiring young lady at Brookfield Central. Despite many personal challenges, she has excelled in advanced classes, served on the executive board of NHS, ran track, was a member of Key Club, Environmental Club, and DECA, worked part-time jobs throughout high school, and was generous of her time. Mia volunteered at a Bible camp for several weeks for two summers and has been very involved in the local Greek community, teaching younger children traditional dances and helping at the annual festival for many years. Mia plans to study biology.
And for the second recipient, Carly Catherine Ramon. Carly is a well-rounded student and accomplished violinist at Brookfield Central. Although she has experienced challenges, she has risen to the occasion for her family, showing maturity and grace. Carly is a varsity lacrosse player, worked on yearbook for 2 years, worked part-time, and was a violinist at the chamber orchestra that played at Carnegie Hall in 2019, helping to fulfill a lifelong dream. Carly's community service includes feeding the homeless, helping with meal programs, and taking mission trips through her church. Carly will be studying film production, digital media, or computer science at DePaul.
Congratulations to Mia and Carly. We are so thrilled for you. And I know that Holly is really proud of the selections for these recipients.
The Jeff Borkowski Musical Theater Scholarship was established to honor Jeff Borkowski, who died of glioblastoma, an aggressive brain cancer, in September of 2017. Jeff attended Elmbrook schools for most of his education, and his children graduated from Brookfield Central, Meg in 2014, Josh in 2016, and Emma in 2017. Jeff, a self-employed builder and remodeler, found it very rewarding to volunteer, helping with stage crew during the Brookfield Central musical. Jeff inspired students with his ability to design and build sets, and was inspired by musical students as he saw them grow over the course of their time in high school. Jeff marveled at the musical process and product that the students were able to be a part of. This impact and value of participating in musical theater is immeasurable. This recipient was a talented student while achieving a high GPA at Brookfield Central. She focused on numerous aspects of the theater department, appearing in fall productions, while also writing for the spring plays. She was a participant in choir, Key Club, and a member of the Alpine Ski Team. During her summer months, she was inspired to teach children at numerous camps. She plans to attend the University of Wisconsin in Madison and major in art education. On behalf of the Borkowski family, I am proud to present the Jeff Borkowski Musical Theater Scholarship to Olivia Kreplin. The Jim Briscoe Honorary Scholarship was established by a single donor who wanted to honor Jim for his many years of leadership at Brookfield Central High School as principal from 1996 until 2002. This endowed fund provides a scholarship to a BCH senior who has overcome challenges to achieve their personal goals. This recipient is a high-achieving student, athlete, and leader at Brookfield Central, lettering in varsity track and field. She was an executive board member of the National Honor Society and participated in Key Club and Spanish Honor Society. Her service extended to the community as a Girl Scout camp counselor and Vacation Bible School leader. She will be attending the University of Minnesota Twin Cities. I am very proud to present the Jim Briscoe Honorary Scholarship to Molly Thomas. The John Boy Memorial Scholarship was established to honor a man who gave his entire career to the education of high school students. John came to BCHS in 1957 as an English and history teacher as well as the tennis coach. He eventually became principal until his retirement in 1988. John believed that what an individual stood for revealed a lot about their character. He valued extracurricular sports, clubs, music, and the arts. This recipient must exhibit excellence in the area of personal character and integrity, academic performance, and extracurricular involvement. This year's recipient was an active participant in school, serving as the Director of Human Resources for the Tyrone newspaper, nominated as MVP and co-captain of the tennis team, and participated in mock trial and alpine ski racing. She also organized and volunteered to teach refugee students English in Milwaukee. She will be majoring in education studies and sociology. The John Boy family is proud to present the John Boy Memorial Scholarship to Ellie Del Campo. The Kevin Dunn Honorary Scholarship is awarded to a graduating senior girl who participated in the Brookfield Central Golf Program for at least 1 year. Family and friends were the most important part of Kevin's life, and he shared his passion for golf with them wholeheartedly. His daughter Grace played on the BC golf team from 2011 until 2015. He often said the most joy he ever experienced from golf was spectating at his daughter's high school and college events. Kevin also loved the lessons golf teaches: integrity, perseverance, respect, and so much more. The recipient of the Kevin Dunn Memorial Scholarship exemplifies all of these qualities. This year's recipient is a high-achieving student that began playing golf her sophomore year and continued through her senior year. She played for both the JV and varsity reserve teams. She also participated in Color Guard, Tyro, Ski Club, and National Honor Society. She also maintained part-time jobs throughout high school and volunteered in her church. In the fall, she will attend the University of Wisconsin-Madison to study communications. Kevin Dunn's family congratulates Emily Otten and wishes her all the best in her future endeavors. The Robin Martino Memorial Scholarship was made possible through the generous donations from our Elmbrook community. Please welcome Robin's daughter, Tori Martino, as she awards the Robin Martino Memorial Scholarship.
Hi there, my name is Tori Martino, and I am Robin Martino's youngest daughter, and I'm here today on behalf of both my sister Talia and my dad Mike, and most of all, I am here on behalf of my mom, Robin Martino. I'm honored to have the opportunity to present this year's Robin Martino Memorial Scholarship, which is a scholarship that was created in honor of my mom, Robin, who was a beloved principal at Wisconsin Hills Middle School for many years. To say the least, the last 6 months or so have been a bit of a whirlwind for our family regrouping to life without Robin. But as many of you know, Robin was a very special soul, and anyone who knew her knew that she made you feel like the most special person in the world, even if she had a million things on her plate. And so it was no surprise to our family when this amazing community here in the Elmbrook School District pulled together this scholarship on her behalf. So I am absolutely honored to be here today to introduce this scholarship. The intention was for the scholarship to go to someone who could live on through my mom's legacy, and someone who really represented the spirit of her most memorable quote, which was, "Make today the best day of your life until tomorrow." And we believe the individual who represents that quote the best is Maggie Conlin. And Maggie, while I don't know you personally, I'm told you had a very special relationship with my mom, and, well, I trust her judgment. I've also heard some really impressive things from all of your faculty and staff and friends here at Brookfield Central. Maggie, you are the founder of Fun Friends at Wisconsin Hills Middle School, a club focused on inclusivity by pairing students with disabilities with typically developing peers. At Brookfield Central, you served on the executive committee and as the president of Best Buddies, a similar organization. I've been told your leadership is evident through your involvement with multiple organizations, the Fellowship of Christian Athletes, DECA, Key Club, Girl Scouts, and National Honor Society, to name a few. Wow, I know that my mom would be incredibly proud. So it's a crazy time to be graduating high school, huh? An even crazier one to be starting the next big chapter of your life, given the current state of everything going on in our world. And I know for many of you, you imagine your high school graduation looking very differently than it will this year. And I know my mom would have had just the perfect words to say during a time like this. But since I know that my words won't come close, I will end with something that I know holds true. Make today the best day of your life until tomorrow. So on behalf of the entire Martino family, I'm very proud to award this year's Martino Scholarship to Maggie Conlin. Congratulations, Maggie.
It would have given Mrs. J great pleasure to see the Vicki Jakubowski Memorial Scholarship awarded. Vicki cared deeply for her students during her 20-plus years in Elmbrook. She always tried to instill in them the qualities she valued, as she did with her own children. She believed in compassion, displayed leadership in the face of adversity, and never shied away from a challenge. Above all, Mrs. J always did everything with passion and joy. In her schoolwork, the no-cut plays she directed, interacting with co-workers, and leadership endeavors. The recipient of this award has displayed these qualities as Mrs. J would have approved. The icing on the cake is that this award should go to a future educator who will take these values and continue to instill them in future generations. This recipient is a very accomplished student. She played tennis throughout high school, serving as the team captain her senior year. She also served on the class council, participated in National Honor Society, girls soccer, and was the manager of the boys' baseball team. She has volunteered as a group leader in Vacation Bible School and confirmation class. She is pursuing a degree in elementary education this fall. Vicki's family is very proud to present the Vicki Jakubowski Memorial Scholarship to Abby Pasternak. The EEF is very grateful for the generosity of our business partners who understand the value a successful public school system brings to the community. Waterstone Bank has been a tremendous supporter of the Elmbrook School District and sponsors the Waterstone Bank Honorary Scholarships. Please welcome Laura Merkel from Waterstone Bank.
On behalf of the bank, I would like to congratulate all of the graduating seniors of Brookfield East and Brookfield Central High Schools. Waterstone Bank is honored to recognize some of Brookfield East and Brookfield Central's most outstanding seniors. These students have demonstrated exceptional character, academic commitment, and a desire to excel in their educational endeavors. Our third recipient is Chandra Shuhan from Brookfield Central. Chandra is an outstanding student at Brookfield Central and is a student leader in numerous organizations, team captain of First Robotics, executive board of student council, school board representative, Hope Squad member, team captain of varsity tennis, and drumline captain, to name a few. Passionate about serving our community, Chandra has volunteered 2 summers at Aurora Psychiatric Hospital and started 2 first robotics teams in our nation's poorest zip code on Milwaukee's south side. In late 2019, Chandra traveled to Capitol Hill to be a voice for change and met with lawmakers to advocate for passing legislation that increases the funding for STEM education throughout the nation. As a first robotics mentor, Shander was recognized as Wisconsin's first LEGO League Mentor of the Year 2 years in a row. Shander will be majoring in neuroscience in the fall. Congratulations.
The Elmbrook Historical Society, Where History Comes Alive, is a nonprofit educational organization founded in 1977. The members care deeply about preserving the history of Brookfield and Elm Grove by collecting and exhibiting objects from the past. Education was important to the first settlers of Brookfield and Elm Grove. Between 1839 and 1867, they built 7 schools so all the area's children would be able to attend school. Today, the Elmbrook School District is one of the top districts in the state. The purpose of this scholarship is to encourage a greater understanding of history and the importance of history in our lives. On behalf of the Elmbrook Historical Society, it gives me great pleasure to notify Tylan Frochnia as the recipient of a $1,000 scholarship. The academic achievements, community service and leadership skills listed on your application demonstrate a determined student with a willingness to work hard. The Elmbrook Historical Society wants to acknowledge and encourage you to continue with your educational endeavors.
To present the next award, we have Mr. Mike Schmeling from Elmbrook Rotary to announce the AVID Scholarship winners.
Rotary International is the world's oldest service club organization with 1.25 million members in over 35,000 clubs in over 200 countries worldwide. Our motto is service above self and seek high ethical standards in our members' personal, business, and professional lives. Where others see problems, Rotary members see solutions. Our members see opportunities and possibilities in their communities and around the world. It's easy to forget in the day-to-day how much we make an impact in our community, locally, regionally, and internationally. As you graduate and move on in your life, I encourage you to join others in your community to work together to be people of action as we consider how we give back. It has been said, we must remember that one determined person can make a significant difference, and that a small group of determined people can change the course of history. The Elmbrook Rotary members are changing history of people's lives we touch, locally through the International Youth Exchange, high school internet programs, and college scholarships, regionally through our literacy programs and food drives, or internationally with our programs in India, Guatemala, Vietnam, and Ecuador, and through our support of international work of Rotary and its foundation. We are indeed changing the world. The Elmbrook Rotary Club is committed to our area youth who will become leaders in our community and around the world. Elmbrook Rotary promotes community service in a variety of ways, including our student interact clubs at Brookfield Central and Brookfield East. In addition to this, we provide 3 scholarships to Elmbrook students every year for post-high school graduate work. 2 scholarships are for $1,000 each for 4 years, and 1 scholarship is $1,000 a year for 2 years. As Nelson Mandela said, we can change the world and make it a better place. It is in our hands to make a difference. Join me this year as we celebrate 2 students this evening as I present our club's annual scholarships. I am proud to present a 4-year scholarship tonight to Emma Harris, who will attend UW-Whitewater to work towards a degree in business management. She then plans to utilize this degree and work in the medical field. I'm also proud to present our 2-year scholarship to Julie Hickey, who will attend Waukesha County Technical College in pursuit of her associate's degree in nursing. Her intent is then to continue on for a master's in nursing and become a nurse practitioner. Congratulations, Em and Julie, and on behalf of the Elmbrook Rotary Club, we congratulate you and send you on to your next adventures with our best wishes. Thank you.
I would like to welcome Adrienne Peterson from the Elm Grove Junior Guild program to present the next scholarship.
Hello, I'm Adrienne Pedersen. On behalf of the Elm Grove Junior Guild Scholarship Committee, I would like to congratulate Lauren Roscoff on earning one of our scholarships. The prompt that we used this year for the essay was about how has your community changed and how have you really impacted that change? What have you done in your community? And let me tell you, Lauren has done so much. She chose the tough topic of teen depression, and then she researched it for hours and hours and put together educational materials for the community. Several of us on Junior Guild commented on how we couldn't even imagine doing something like that in high school, let alone now as adults. So Lauren truly deserves this scholarship. We are so proud of her, and we're looking forward to seeing what she does next.
I would like to extend a welcome to Ms. Leslie Dean from the Waukesha County Community Foundation.
Hi, I'm Leslie Dean, Scholarship Coordinator for the Waukesha County Community Foundation. WCCF is a pool of permanent endowment and project funds created by and for the people of Waukesha County to provide grants support to charitable organizations. The intent of the foundation is to serve a broad spectrum of community needs, including scholarships. The first scholarship I would like to present is the Glenn Davis Scholarship. The Glenn Davis Charitable Fund was established in 1975 to honor our former Congressman Glenn Davis. Glenn Davis served in the U.S. House of Representatives for 20 years and is the only person born in Waukesha County to have represented us there. Each year, the fund awards a scholarship to a graduating senior at the 17 main high schools in the county. The award is not necessarily for the highest GPA or a top sports or arts talent, but rather for a student who has barriers and hurdles to succeed. The 2020 Glenn Davis Scholarship recipient is Tyler Babaloa. The next scholarship is the Stoll Family Scholarship. The Stoll Family Scholarship was created for a student who demonstrates a need, who positively represents their school and the community, and who demonstrates having a maximized effort throughout high school. Ken and Judy Stoll believe that with success comes the responsibility of giving back, and they cherish the value of education. Ken spent some of his childhood in Milwaukee before moving to Brookfield, where he attended Brookfield Central High School. Judy grew up in West Dallas and attended West Allis Central. Ken studied at Marquette, St. Thomas, Loyola, and Judy studied at UWM, University of Minnesota, and Northeastern Illinois University. The 2020 Stoll Family Scholarship recipient is Ryla Cluck. Congratulations to all the scholarship recipients and the class of 2020.
Good evening. I am Lenny Johnson, a member of the Elm Grove Golden K Kiwanis and the advisor to the Brookfield Central Clee Club. Along with me this evening is Norm Thorson, the president of our club, who will announce this year's scholarship recipients. Our mission, as all of the Kiwanis clubs, is to support the needs of children throughout the world. Most Kiwanis clubs sponsor high school key clubs. Our club is extremely fortunate to be associated with the best, largest, and most active key club in the state, and that is Brookfield Central. They have over 325 active members. In a normal year, they will do over 9,000 community service hours. That's 9,000. The success of the club can be attributed to the dedication and the enthusiastic direction from the teacher advisors, Mr. Ron Blaha and Mr. Scott Nelson. For the last 4 years, fortunately for me, I have been our Key Kiwanis Club's advisor to the Brookfield Central Key Club. Doing this has given me the opportunity to see firsthand what great individuals they are and see the benefits they receive from being active Key Club members. Let me take a moment to illustrate those benefits. Once a service project is approved, a student volunteers to manage the project. Management entails the student manager contacting the service volunteer coordinator to determine what needs to be done, the number of students required, where it is located, and when they are needed. The student project manager must convince Key Club members to sign up and work the project. The manager must also arrange for transportation to the work site. At the site, the manager must see that all Key Club volunteers are doing what is expected of them. Regardless of whether the student is a project leader or a volunteer worker working on different projects out in the community, they will see firsthand the various needs individuals and service organizations have. They are definitely working outside of their comfort zones. As you can see, I am definitely sold on the benefits of Brookfield Central Key Club. Therefore, I'm asking you parents to consider promoting the Key Club for students you now have at Brookfield Central and for those who will be attending Central in the future. Now, Norm Thorson will announce the recipients of this year's scholarships.
Thank you, Lenny. I'm Norm Thorson, the president of the Elm Grove Kiwanis Golden K. And this year we have 5 scholarships to represent to the students. The 2020 scholarships this year will go to Riley Fing, Sammy Krutz, and Nicole Yang. Their scholarships are for $1,000 each. And now we have 2 special scholarships, a Bob Cummisford scholarship. Bob was a longtime dedicated member of our Elm Grove Golden K Kiwanis and an early advisor to the Brookfield Central Key Club. He passed away last year, and a memorial fund was established by his family to be given as scholarships to Brookfield Central Key Club students in his name. And we are presenting 2 scholarships, Angela Logan and Mary Quinn, in the amount of $700 each. We really appreciate the work that all of the Key Club students have done.
In closing, both Norm and I, along with all the members of the Elm Grove Kiwanis Club, want to wish the graduating Key Club seniors all the success in the future. And we hope that they will continue to give of their time and talent to those in need. Thank you.
The BC Lancer Athletic Booster Club works year-round to raise funds to support our athletes and teams, as well as fund capital improvements such as the locker rooms and concession facilities. Additionally, each year the Booster Club is proud to help our athletes in their academic pursuits by providing a $1,000 scholarship to 1 male and 1 female athlete. Their selection process is a blind review. The applicants' names are blacked out and not revealed to the scholarship selection committee. The scholarships are awarded to senior athletes who meet the academic criteria and best exemplify effort, dedication, commitment, leadership, and spirit. Our female athlete recipient displayed dedication and commitment by being a 3-sport athlete for all 4 years. Her main sports were soccer and basketball, in which she was a 3-year varsity member and team captain her senior year. Her junior year, she earned second team all-conference for soccer. As a tennis player, she played on the JV team and was voted MVP by her teammates during her sophomore through senior years. Her soccer coach, Dan Mackle, has high praise for her spirit and team focus. I can attest to the incredible work ethic and positivity that she brings to our team. She always looks to do what is best for all involved rather than what is best for herself. Coach Mackle also recognizes her leadership ability and noted she is capable of handling leadership roles with confidence and determination. Outside of sports, she is a two-year member of the Student Council, Executive Board, and Blue Crew, and a two-time national qualifier for DECA. She carries a 4.3 grade point average and will be attending the University of Wisconsin-Madison. I'm pleased to announce the 2020 Female Athletic Booster Club Scholarship recipient, Emily Bush. Our male athlete exemplifies effort, dedication, commitment, and leadership through his participation in football, wrestling, track and field, and baseball. He competed on varsity an astounding 13 of 16 seasons. He received numerous recognitions in football, including two-time All-Conference, All-County, and All-Region. In wrestling, he picked up the sport as a freshman, won half his matches as a junior, and became a state qualifier and team captain as a senior. His wrestling coach, Chris Demas, spoke of his dedication and commitment, saying, "He is one of the more responsible, self-directed high school athletes I have ever worked with." Coach Demas also talks about his spirit and leadership by noting, "While his role and responsibilities have evolved over the years, his mission to grow as a team has never wavered." In addition to his athletic pursuits, he volunteers his time as a youth football and baseball coach. He carries a 4.3 grade point average and will be attending USC. It is my pleasure to announce the 2020 Male Athletic Booster Club Scholarship recipient, Tommy Maurice.
Our next presenter is Mrs. Karen Selke from the Applause Booster Club.
Hi, my name is Karen Selke, and I am here representing the BCHS Applause Booster Club for the Fine Arts. We are a parent and student organization that supports all the students here at Brookfield Central who are involved with the Fine Arts. We support the band, choir, orchestra, dramatic and musical arts, digital imaging, creative media, and the visual arts. Today, I'm proud to recognize the senior applause members who best exemplify effort, dedication, commitment, and spirit regardless of the level of success they've received on the stage, in the gallery, or in another capacity. The awards will recognize the fine arts student who gives his or her best effort, pitches in to help others, and encourages fellow students to excel. This year we did something a little different. We had all our scholarship applicants present a 2 to 5 minute video application. These videos were judged by 6 judges, all talented, practicing artists from across the country. They were overwhelmed by the talent, passion, and dedication of our students. And we at Applause agree with the judges. And it is for that reason that we are presenting $4,000 worth of scholarships to 8 deserving students. And with no further ado, I'd like to present 4 $250 bronze scholarships. The first recipient at the bronze level is Lauren Roskopf. The second recipient is Rhea Ramachandran. The third recipient is Annabelle Gilson. And the fourth recipient of the bronze level is Megan Brown. Congratulations to all our bronze winners. And now on to our silver level winners, who will each receive a $500 scholarship. The first recipient is Olivia Kreplin, who has been active in both musical and dramatic theater, choir, and digital and visual arts throughout her 4 years at Central. The second recipient of our silver scholarship is Caitlin Ellentenny, who participated in musical and dramatic theater, visual art classes, and creative media. Congratulations, Olivia and Caitlin. Finally, our gold scholarship winners, who will each receive an $1,000 scholarship. Samantha Cobb. During Sam's 4 years at BC, she's been involved in musical theater and dramatic theater, choir, and many community theater productions. As one judge said, "Samantha's passion and spirit for the arts are irrepressible. Samantha appears to be a leader, a creative person, and has the necessary drive to either pursue theater as a profession or to use her passion and experience to drive her future interests and engagement in her community. Bravo. Our second gold $1,000 scholarship goes to Anya Logan. During her high school career, Anya's been active in BCHS Band, WSMA Solo and Ensemble, Milwaukee Youth Symphony Orchestra, mentored students at Brookfield Elementary fourth grade band, and was a BCHS drum major for the marching band her senior year. As one judge said, Anya clearly demonstrates great enthusiasm and passion for music and has a high level of serious dedication and talent as a young horn player. It is notable that she took the risk of trying new instruments within the brass family, trumpet and trombone, along the way. Her abilities have been recognized in multiple ways in her community and elsewhere. Congratulations to both of you. Thank you.
The Lila Draper Trust Fund was established as a result of a bequest by Lila Draper Burton, a Waukesha County resident, indicating her faith in the young people of Waukesha County and her belief in the value of an education. The scholarship is a four-year, $1,200 per year, or $1,800 per year if attending Carroll University, and is awarded to Waukesha County seniors who show scholarship, character, and school citizenship. Each year, we nominate three students for this scholarship. The following students were this year's nominees: Julia Papilla, Tirza Sonderman, and Madeline Walensky. We'd like to congratulate all three students for being nominated for this award. While none of them won this year, we're extremely proud of their efforts.
Our next presenter is Mr. Jerry Homan. He is here to announce the Luke Homan Foundation Scholarship recipients.
Hello, everyone. My name is Jerry Homan, and I'm here to present the Luke Homan Memorial Scholarships. I'm very privileged to be able to do this. Unfortunately, they're to honor my son who has passed away or died in 2006, so it's been a while. And also, most of you recipients, or all you kids that are graduating this year, were probably 1 year old, maybe 2 years old at the most when my son was graduating from Brookfield Central. So obviously you didn't have any personal contact with him. Maybe heard stories about him. I know anyone that's been in the gym, in the new gym, can see his jersey up there, the number 32 on the wall. And that was my son. He was a great athlete here at Brookfield Central. Loved playing sports, had a lot of friends, made a lot of friends through sports, through school, other activities outside of school. And unfortunately, for these scholarships that we're giving, we only have five that we gave out, and we had 21 applicants. And they all were great applicants. I don't know if it's because of your ability to have more time to do the presentations, but they all were very good. And it was a tough decision to decide on just five. I wish I could have given one to everyone. But some things that I've realized in the last 2 months here is how important family is, how important, I guess, your health and your family are over just about everything else. You can always go out and make money. You can always do this or that, but your family is there, and sometimes it's for a short time. We had Luke just for 21 years, but certainly enjoyed and loved those 21 years more than anything else. And it's my honor to give five scholarships, as I said, and I will read the names right now, and the scholarships will be here at Brookfield Central, so you can get them. Either they'll mail them to you, or you can come and pick them up however they decide to do it. Excuse me for my pronunciation of some of the names, but here are the five people. As I said, all 21 were great, and wish we could give everyone one, but it's not monetarily possible for us. Terzad Sonderman, Isabella Demsma, Lucas Schmidt, Sammy Kuntz, or Krutz, K-R-U-T-Z, and Gina Alteri. And hopefully we all get through this period right now and come out of it healthy and, I guess, wiser. But hopefully down the road. I can see you five people sometime and say congratulations to you personally, but I just want you to enjoy these scholarships and use them to the best ability in promoting your education to whatever school you're going to. And hopefully we do have, or you kids do have college, because college is a great experience, and you're going to look back when you get to be an old codger like me, and you're going to say, boy, those are four or five of the best years of my life. And enjoy them while you can, put the effort forward, and do your best in academically and anything else, any other activities you are in at the school. But enjoy them and make the best of it. Thank you.
It is my pleasure to introduce Ms. Teresa Clementson from the Michelle Whitmer Foundation to present the next scholarship.
Hello, good evening. My name is Teresa Clementson, and I'm the Vice Commander, Junior Vice Commander at VFW Post 8320. We every year give a scholarship called the Michelle Whitmer Memorial Community Service Scholarship. I'm just going to read a little bit about this, and then I will announce this year's recipient. So Michelle Whitmer attended Waukesha West School for 2 years before moving to New Berlin and finishing high school through a satellite school program. Michelle joined the Wisconsin Army National Guard and was a member of the 32nd Military Police Company in Milwaukee. The MP Company received orders for deployment in Iraq in 2003. On April 9th, 2004, while returning back to their base camp, the Humvee which Michelle was riding in was ambushed by an improvised explosive device, IED, and a small arms fire from the enemy. Michelle lost her life in that firefight. She was the first female soldier killed in action in the 167th year of history of the Wisconsin Army National Guard. Michelle loved committing her off-duty time by working with disabled children at an orphanage in Baghdad, Iraq. She grew to appreciate the people of Iraq and their way of life. So every year, again, like I said, we give away this scholarship. We are her post in Brookfield 8320. And I'd like to announce this year's recipient as Daphne Milkert. She has received this year. Thanks a lot, Daphne, and good luck with your college, and take care. See you maybe in the future. My son just joined the Wisconsin Army National Guard, so maybe you will also. Thanks. Okay, bye.
Hi. Congratulations, class of 2020. My name is Karen Hughes, and my family and I are here to award the Mike Hughes Memorial Scholarship for the 17th year at Brookfield Central. Because of the unique circumstances of this year, my children and grandchildren and I are all involved in awarding the scholarship.
This is a crazy year with the COVID-19 pandemic making it impossible for us to gather and support the achievements of the class of 2020 in person.
We recognize this is a tough year for all students, especially seniors, who may feel they are missing out on enjoying the recognition and ceremonies that typically honor their years of hard work.
We're sorry your senior year was impacted this way.
And to honor this unique graduating class, we wanted to do something creative and fun to announce this year's winner by having all the members of Mike Hughes' family participate from across the country at their various quarantine locations.
This scholarship is in memory of our dad, Mike Hughes, who was an active, involved parent in the lives of all four of us kids, all of whom attended Brookfield Central High School. Over the past 17 years, we've awarded scholarships to 23 deserving students.
Each year, we look for a candidate who personifies what Mike Hughes stood for: love of family, sense of humor, appreciation for life's simple joys, and giving back to the community.
Each year, we continue to have excellent candidates, and I want to thank each of you for your heartfelt applications. We chose a candidate who we believe embodies our dad Mike Hughes' spirit and priorities in life. It is our pleasure to award the Mike Hughes Memorial Scholarship for 2020 to Lauren Roscoff. Congratulations, Lauren. Congratulations, class of 2020. And let the music play.
Hello, I am so proud to be the advisor for the BCAHS NHS. National Honor Society is comprised of students who demonstrate excellence in the area of scholarship, leadership, service, and character. On behalf of the Brookfield Central Chapter of NHS, I am proud to award four $500 scholarships this evening to members who epitomize those four pillars of our organization. This decision was a very hard one to make because our NHS is filled with amazing students, and I truly wish that I could give an award to each one of you that applied. For those senior members that are watching, please know that I appreciate all that you've done for NHS this year. The first scholarship is awarded to Tirza Sonderman. Tirza is a member of the NHS Exec Board. She ran our tutoring program this year. She added to this program by offering tutoring not only to BCAHS, but also to Wisconsin Hills Middle School. When we went virtual, she was able to work through this and create a wonderful virtual tutoring program for both the schools as well. Tirza, I believe your tutoring legacy will continue for many years to come. Congratulations and thank you for all your hard work. Our second scholarship goes to Exec Board member Norman Liu. Norman was our organizer extraordinaire this year. He made sure all our meeting presentations were fun and ready to go. He was instrumental in organizing our Hope for the Holidays event, mask making drive, made our induction ceremony absolutely fabulous, and so many, many other opportunities he offered to our members. I am not sure what I'm going to do without you next year, Norman, but thank you and congratulations. Our third scholarship is awarded to Mia Lyakopoulos. As a member of the exec board, Mia always came from a place of yes. She was someone I could turn to in a last minute pinch and she would get it done. But even more often, she would just stop by and ask if anything needed to be done. Mia, I'm not sure how we're gonna fill those shoes next year. So congratulations and thank you again. Our last and final scholarship is awarded to Julia Fernandez. As a member of NHS, Julia was involved with many of our volunteer opportunities, but where she really shined was in tutoring. She was so friendly and easy to approach, and it's no wonder that that was what impacted her the most in her time in NHS. Congratulations, Julia.
Thank you for watching the BC Class of 2020 Honors Night program. It was not the same thing as being together, but it's inspiring to see the accolades that were awarded tonight. I am proud of everyone. Seniors, this school year and our lives took a big detour. But remember, with persistence and resilience, all detours will eventually take you back to your normal route. Cherish the days that you are spending with your families, and remember to search the world for the positives and never, never miss a chance to say thank you. And after today, we are one day closer to being back together. Have a great rest of the evening.